Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Billy Rohan. We're back again with the second edition of VHS Days. Last time we got to check out some old favorites, and today we're gonna check out some old favorites. It's just one of those things, like when you watch VHSs, you remember like skating was so different back then. And not everybody was super amazing on a skateboard from all the parks, but when you saw something new in a video, you were just blown away by it. And when you watch some of these VHSs now, you realize these dudes were that amazing 20 years ago. So right now we're gonna check out the old Plan B Secondhand Smoke video. We're gonna watch Rodney Mullen's part. He's a fellow Gainesville, Florida Gators guy. We both went to the same high school. Pretty wild. Small town stuff right there. All right, we got Rodney Mullen's part right here from Secondhand Smoke, the old Plan B video. And it's an interesting thing about Rodney Mullen because we both grew up in Gainesville, Florida, one of the smallest liberal towns in the South. And we actually went to the same high school together. Rodney went to Gainesville High School, and there was all these legendary stories about him. And we were, I don't know, maybe 15 years apart in age. But when I was at school and I was a skater, the teachers would say, hey, do you know Rodney Mullen? Have you ever heard of Rodney Mullen? I said, yeah, of course I've heard of Rodney Mullen. And there was these stories about Rodney Mullen practicing freestyle in the hallways all night long, throughout the night, and then coming to school the next day, super sweaty and dirty. And the kids would be like, yeah, I heard he used to take acid and just practice freestyle all night. And then I realized as I got older, it wasn't that he was taking acid, it was that he was just that tripped out of a dude. Like, he was so into what he was doing. When I actually first met Rodney Mullen in real life, it was at Tampa Pro, and it was during a time where I'd been hearing about him for almost 20 years, and I finally got to meet him. We were teammates on Globe together, and I was super depressed. I had been going through a really hard time in life, dealing with like all sorts of problems. And I remember I saw him in the hallway at the La Quinta Inn in this like shitty area of Tampa. And he goes, Billy, why are you upset? You have such a bright future ahead of you. And that's just the type of dude he is. Like, Rodney Mullen is almost like an astrophysicist of skateboarding. Like, he's so intelligent that it's like smart people sound like crazy people to dumb people. And when you talk to somebody like Rodney Mullen, if you're not on point, the dude could come across as like a totally insane person, but it's actually like talking to an Einstein in the skate world. A lot of people don't know that Rodney Mullen owns tons of patents in the US Patent Office, having to do with skateboarding, having to do with designs for trucks, but also having to do with real life technology. If you ever watch Rodney Mullen's TED Talks, where he actually gets on stage and does a whole talk about the relationship of skateboarding, architecture, and the mind that gets developed from people in the sport itself, of this idea that you start out skateboarding and people tell you you'll never be able to do a kickflip. Those people don't skate. And when you try it over and over and over, and all of a sudden you've done your first kickflip, you realize that everything people have told you in the world is bullshit, and that if you work hard on anything, you can make it a reality. And it's one of those things that when like people want to talk to me about skateboarding, they've never really understood it, I like to play Rodney Mullen's TED Talk, because it's kind of one of those things that just breaks down the science of how difficult it is. I mean, whether you like his style or not, that's a whole different thing, you know? But it's like Rodney Mullen is basically a street skateboarding ballerina. Like, this dude is by far the most technically advanced skater, even from the 80s, when people weren't doing ollies, they weren't doing kickflips. He was doing all the shit that you see today, the flip-ins, flip-outs, you know, 20 years ago, before anybody even thought it was possible. Because the mind of Rodney Mullen works in the scientific way, where he's actually looking at his board thinking how much pressure needs to be applied to make a half of a milliflip, rather than like, I'm gonna go and just huck myself down this big gap and hope that I get on the cover. You know, he's looking at it from an artistic point of view, like a dancer or a gymnast or even like a kung fu master, is just the type of person he is. And I think even if Rodney Mullen didn't have any money and he was just homeless and a skateboarder in a parking lot, his natural ability is what makes him happy. It's like through the gates of art, we enter the temple of happiness. Rodney Mullen's an artist. Hey, so I hope you guys enjoyed volume 2 of VHS Days. Got to catch up on a little skateboarding history. Remind you that these dudes been doing this stuff for a long time before a lot of you kids were born out there, and they're still doing it. It's like fine wine. Used to think it was over at 30, but now these guys are in their thirsty 30s and they're just doing what they do. So we'll see you on the next volume. Hope you enjoyed it. Peace.